next morning, the Fed controller spoke in severely to James. If you can't behave, they shall take away your red coat and have you painted blue, sir, there. James did not like that at all. And he was ever rough at the coaches and feeling ever cross. He felt his position inside himself looking ever tough and ever well tensed up. He brought the coaches to the platform. Come along, come along, he called rudely. All in good time, all in good time. Bow, 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 bow. The coaches grumbled. Oh, don't talk, come on, answered James. And with the coaches screaming and grumbling after him, he snorted into the station. James was ever cross that ever fine summer morning. The Fed controller had spoken to him. The coaches had dawdled, and worst of all, he had to fetch his own coaches. Oh no, his temper's getting even worse. Even worse. Gordon never does, thought James. He's only painted blue. A splendid red engine like me should never have to fetch his own coaches. And he puffed and snorted round to the front of the train and backed onto it with a rude bump. Like I said, he wasn't being gentle. He was being rough. It was too bad. To make James even more cross, he then had to take the coaches to a different platform where no one came near him. She stood there. The Fed controller was in his office. The station master was at the other end of the train, and he was not alone. Not alone. He was not alone. He was with the guard. And even the little boy stood a long way off. James felt lonely. Lonely in one spot of the station. Out her, then, he said to himself. I think Gordon is that only engine who can pull coaches. As soon as the guard's whistle blew, he started off with a tremendous jerk. Squealing and groaning in protest, clattered over the points onto the open line. Hubby, 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 puffed James.
Faster, 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 faster.
You're going too fast, you're going too fast, you're going too fast, said the coaches. And indeed, they were going fast. But they swayed from side to side. James laughed and tried to go faster, but the coaches wouldn't let him. We're going to stop, we're going to stop, we're going to stop, they said. always find yourself getting slower and slower. "What's the matter?" asked James. "Just the brakes are hard on leaking the pipe, most likely. You've banged the curtains enough to make a leak in anything." The guard and the driver got down and looked at the brake pipes all along the train. At last, they found a hole, a rough treatment made the joint work loose. "How's she mended?" said the guard. James's driver thought for a moment. "All taut with newspapers and a leather bootlace." "Well, where is the bootlace coming from?" asked the guard. "We haven't one. Ask the passengers," said the driver. So the guard made everyone get out. "Has anybody got a leather bootlace?" he asked. They all said no. But there was somebody else out for chuff. There was a crick that James just found. And what he saw was some objects that Thomas met. It was 10 cents and sunshine. The guard stopped them and asked them if they had some bootlaces. "Do you two have some bootlaces?" he asked.
That's me. I don't have bootlaces," said 10 cents.
"But you've got some," said Sunshine. Sunshine gave the guard the bootlaces. Then he took the pad of newspaper round the hill to stop the leak. And James is able to pull the train again. But he was a sadder and wiser James, and took some never to bump curtains again, because it is not great. 10 cents and sunshine spoke him sternly. "Now you don't forget what we're saying, James, lad," said Sunshine. "You can't bump curtains." "They don't like it," said 10 cents, "because they get cross and will pay out. We'll have to report this to the Fed controller." James knew they were right. He left. He was feeling a bit sad. It had just learned one little small thing.